What's up, everybody? I'm the BurningSkyCloud. Welcome back to Life is Strange, Before the Storm. So, let's see. In the last episode... Okay, Rachel's here. In the last episode, we got to have some hangout time with Rachel. Ooh, and look at this. Sounds like Chloe has a crush on her. Oh, shit. That was not supposed to happen. I was here, so next. You know something? I wonder if at the end of the original Life is Strange that Max got to read all of Chloe's information. Oh, and another thing that I needed to look at. Not you. So, dead one guy, happy brat, and the old car. Okay. So I know what I'm doing. Anyway, I guess we're continuing games.
This whole day is out of order. But in the best possible way. Damn, that's an old tree. Wait, does this sign say butt rot?
Butt rot? Estimates age the tree at 400 to 450 years old, though interior butt rot. Butt rot. Let's see.
Looks like this one might actually be working. That is the look of a person who is used to getting what she wants. Wonder what that feels like.
I do too wonder what it feels like. Rachel, I'm trying to look at the oak tree.
The lonely oak looks lonely. Guess even trees have outcasts.
Trees are right where they need to be.
Rachel's quarter is still trapped in there, waiting to be set free.
Let's investigate.
Looks like I might be able to pry it open with the right tool.
Let's see if I can't pry it open.
I'm not getting in there with just my fingers. Maybe Rachel has something I can use.
Alright, let's investigate the statue. Dwight Mueller. Dwight, do you have anything that you could, I
Dwight
can use?
Dwight Mueller really killed it with this statue of an explorer guy. Where are all my explorer ladies at, though? Probably at home, washing laundry and spitting out kids. Fuck you, Dwight.
Law. Oh!
Is this how historic axe murderers searched for their next victim?
That's the dead white guy. Yeah, let's do that, huh? But which answer is it? Is it a me answer or a Chloe answer?
Stop sextanting the interns.
Pioneer spirit. I'm a pioneer, baby. I just need the outfit for it.
Just a day in the park with Rachel Amber.
Oh, I love
you know when
the silence.
Something kind of amazing is happening, you don't always stop to think about it right away. And then when you do think about it, you start thinking about it a lot. And the more you think about it, the crazier it seems, until pretty soon you're psyching yourself out and then everything turns to shit. Yeah, let's not do that today.
Sure, let's not. Thinking too much is a crime in itself. Can I go this way? Ooh, tire swing!
If Max were here, she'd probably take a black and white photograph and call it Innocence Lost, or some shit.
Squirrels!
I guess nature doesn't quite provide.
Why should I scare them?
I wonder if I could use this to get the quarter out.
In honor of Martin Lewis Prescott, Arcadia Bay's greatest son and greatest asshole. I can actually leave Rachel for a little while?
Yuck. Cliche much, AW and OL?
I've been saying sorry all morning. I admit it was really dumb to lock the keys in the car. You've been on me for 3 hours.
Huh. That sounds like a job for Chloe to come to the rescue.
Yep, it's official. I'm learning way more ditching school than I ever do in class.
Yeah, I would say so. You learn a lot more in the real world than you do ever have done in class. Like, school does not prepare you for anything in life. The Salishan tribe totem pole. The raven stands for transformation. Its grinning face betrays its trickster spirit. The raven has many ancient stories among the Salishan and other native peoples. Some say the raven helped create the first man. The raven is to be respected. Never trust it. Never more.
Whoa. That's badass.
I wonder what they thought of in the past that made them believe in totem spirits.
My hierarchy of needs goes pot, then beer, then wine. Still, wino has a classy ring to it. If you're going to argue in public, at least have the decency to make it about something interesting.
We'll make it interesting, Chloe.
Hey, spare some change?
Sorry, we might have some leftover food when we're done.
What? No, I'm not. What kind of food?
This place has really gone downhill.
Shh. She's right there.
Not a hobo. I'm honest. I am not a hobo. I don't live around here. And definitely didn't ditch school. History placard.
This Blackwall guy sure liked founding stuff that was already there. Founders keepers, I guess.
If you found something that was already there, is it truly a discovery? That is the question that must be asked. How far can I go?
I don't want to head down there just yet.
Alright, well, we talked with the arguing couple. Let's talk to Rachel. Maybe she has something.
I'm thinking about prying open that viewfinder. Got a knife on you?
A knife?
Yeah. My mom took mine.
No. How about a nail file?
I mean, that
I guess
work.
You could stab someone with a nail file.
It's very possible.
Oh, right. Sure, let's try it.
Chloe Price. Fluorine, uranium, carbon, potassium, uranium. Think I don't know that spells. Fuck you on the periodic table? Got in trouble for that. You carbon, uranium. Nitro, tin. Oh! Wait. Fuck poo. That's not a K. That's a P. You called me a cunt. Huh? Tin is SN. Grammatically trying to correct her when she's threatening us. I mean, Chloe wouldn't give two shits.
Damn it. It always looks so easy in the movies. Wonder if I can find something sturdier to use.
Wait, don't we have the nail file? Wait. She mentioned about this, so... this bench is no longer honorary. We remove your honor.
Stealing a dedication plate takes persistence.
Hey, heads up. Wells is on the warpath. Uh-oh. Yeah, right? You're killing this morning. That's what the GM does, dude. Also, thanks for playing with us. Mikey had a blast. He's cool. He's been down lately. Not sure why, but I know playing with you really meant a lot. Principal Wells is going to find that two of his most valued students are gone. Alright, let's pry this baby open, shall we?
Got power activate.
Well, now it's really out of order.
I win. That was enough of a game for me. Your MacGyver skills are second to none. Except, probably... MacGyver.
We don't talk about MacGyver.
Rachel smells like... jasmine? Is she smelling me right now, too? Really should have showered this morning.
All right, here's the game. You find some people for us to spy on, and then you and I will act out what they're saying and thinking.
That's it? I do that in my head during, like, every class.
See? You're a natural. Let's give it a try.
What is that? Well, first... this could be fun.
Hey, what do you say we barbecue some squirrels when we're done here?
God, you just have the best ideas.
Squirrel meat!
They totally stole my third grade art project. Wow, you made that?
Can't you tell?
It does have a certain give zero fucks quality that I recognize.
Couple holding hands.
All right. Let's see.
Why do we always hold hands like this? Didn't you tell me you were ambidextrous?
No, I didn't. I said I was ambisexual.
Oh, so you can have sex with both of your hands?
Exactly. Wanna see?
Only if you let go of my hand first.
Okay, they're done.
What's going on with these two?
And the Lord saideth, thou shalt make a burnt offering of your firstborn son.
Who are you talking to, Dad?
No one, son. Now, lean into the grill and see if the fire started. Further.
Further.
Wow. That was dark. Too dark. Perfect dark.
We shall sacrifice the children of the night.
Loving this guy. What's he thinking right now?
No matter how fast I go, I'll never outwalk this wedgie.
That's so tragic, but also beautiful.
I mean, honestly, so in the last episode, he was kind of running like he had a wedgie up his butt.
This is fun. Who's next? Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to hog the viewfinder. Ooh, jackpot. Commence makeout session in 3, 2, 1. Nailed it. Damn, they are really going at it.
Oh, honey, I think we used the vibrating bed for too long. I'm totally seeing double.
Rachel? Hey, are you all right?
What are we doing?
Excuse me?
Last I checked, you're supposed to be Chloe Price. Yet we've been ditching now for hours, and we haven't even gotten wasted yet. That's got to be against some school ditching rule.
Oh, for a minute there, I honestly thought that she was gonna be like suddenly all like, what are we doing? You're Chloe Price. We shouldn't be ditching school like this. And I would have been like, I'm sorry. What? I'm confused. Why are you suddenly changing your mind about ditching?
Hell yeah. The honor student wants to show the school delinquent how to party? Be my guest.
How gracious of you.
Like, didn't have to get so angry about it.
They have a bottle of wine.
Let's steal it.
Okay. Or we could go try to find a liquor store instead.
No.
You think they're gonna let us in?
You shouldn't bring alcohol to a public park if you're not willing to share it with everybody, right? And fuck it. I just want to take something that's not mine. All right.
Haven't we all at one point?
Try to keep up. Can we help you? Oh my god!
Holy shit! Talk about committing to a performance. Better act fast.
Kleptomanian is the best.
Oh, whoop. Thank god! Please, this girl is in trouble! Go get help!
Alright.
I need to get these two to focus on Rachel so I can swipe the wine.
What are you waiting for? Go!
Still...
I've seen this kind of thing before. This woman clearly has a wound that needs to be sterilized. Do you happen to have any alcohol?
I didn't see a wound. Look closer.
In the meantime, I'll search for the booze.
I screwed up.
Hold on. There's something off about this. Are you girls putting us on? Rachel! Run!
What the hell?
I screwed that up. I panicked. Nice going! I screwed that one up so bad.
So... maybe your acting could use a little work, but at least you committed to the performance.
thanks.
It doesn't really give you any time to really think.
I could use a drink after trying to keep up with you.
I am excessively sober right now.
Right. Okay. Guess we're leaving now.
I honestly hate this time limit thing. It gives you, like, what, maybe 5 seconds to actually think about what answer to give? I need, like, 30 seconds. No, maybe 20. 15. Little birdie, tweet tweet. We are so grounded. But, who cares, right?
Whoa. Hey, check this out.
What?
Ooh? Oh, is this junkyard? Yeah, it's a junkyard.
Great. It's a pile of trash.
Yeah. An awesome pile of trash.
Let's explore.
You have fun, Chloe. I'm gonna go sit down.
Rachel's been acting kind of standoffish ever since we left the park. What's her deal?
I've heard that actors are moody, but wow, Rachel.
I'm not moody. I just need some space. Is that all right with you?
Okay.
Actually, no. I thought we were having a great day together. Why are you acting like this all of a sudden?
I'm not acting like anything. I just want to be left alone right now.
Yeah, I get it. I know I'm not the easiest person to be around. I don't exactly have tons of experience with the whole friendship thing.
Not everything revolves around you, Chloe.
I didn't say it did. I'm just saying I understand.
No, you really don't.
Fuck!
Okay, I still have no idea what's going on with Rachel, but apparently she gets smashy when she's angry. I can work with that.
Did it have something to do with the couple? The guy and Skull. The girl?
Hey, check it out.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer drinking it next to an old toilet.
Home run!
Can I see?
Sure.
I asked you to leave me alone.
Are you kidding me? I know you're the school princess and all, with the DA daddy and the perfect grades and all the perfect little Victoria Chases kissing your perfect ass. But seriously,
Fuck you. Great. I'm leaving. See you around, Chloe.
You can't leave!
Watch me.
Rachel, wait! Don't go.
I probably should have just left her alone.
Why not? Because I don't want to ruin this the way I ruin everything else in my life. And what is this exactly?
What will I choose?
I mean, fuck. Are you actually going to make me say it? Say what exactly? You know, like a friendship. But more. Ah. I know. Weird, right? It's just, today was the best day I've had since my dad died. And when I almost ruined it just now, the way I ruin everything, it made me realize whatever's going on between us is special. Come on, say something. Chloe, I, you know what? Forget it. This was really stupid. I mean, you're Rachel Amber, and I'm Chloe Price. It's not that. It's just hard right now. And I can't talk about it. Why not? Because I can't. I know it isn't fair, but it's how it is. Goodbye, Chloe.
This game throws everything at you.
Fuck this place.
Uh-oh. I knew I shouldn't have done it. Smash. What if I don't leave? Is she gonna smash the mirror? No, I guess not. Oh, okay. I guess you did.
I'm not finished. Not yet.
I mean, if I had left her alone and gone back, would it have mattered? Would it have made a difference? Yeah, screw that bottle. Screw this old monitor. You ever just wanted to take a bat to things? Just destroy them? Hey, that still had paint in there.
You know she's fake, You can't take your eyes off her. Who else do I know who fits that description? Yeah! Fuck off, Rachel.
Oh, look at that! That's the truck! That's the truck that becomes Chloe's! Is there anything else? Box of junk? More like box of scattered camera?
I've never understood your hard-on for cameras, Max. You took a million pictures of us, and not one of them showed that you were gonna leave when I needed you most. Fuck cameras. If you want to rip a family apart from the inside, it's important to bring the proper tools. Fuck you, David.
Probably wasn't the best place to actually come.
I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend.
Why are you crying, sweetheart?
Ah,
because you're not real.
I'm not.
What is going on?
What? That's the question I have. What is happening? I'm scared.
What's past is prologue and shit.
Kiddo, look on the bright side, would ya?
What bright side?
You made a new friend today.
My marker.
We'll find it in a minute.
There it is.
Why is it?
Gotta say, that was some fight. A lover's quarrel, you might say? She nearly took your head off.
What do you care?
Sorry, sweetheart. I guess I'm getting into your personal business.
Okay, we're gonna graffiti this car. I probably missed another one. Yeah, I missed number 9.
Dad used to hate it when I wrote on shit. Sleep is for the weak. I guess I did that.
Sometimes people need you, though. Even when they don't admit it.
Okay, she's on fire.
Rachel.
That accursed truck again. What is going on? It's like we're diving headfirst into a horror game suddenly. Follow the Raven. Get the feeling that the Raven might be William.
You came.
I'm glad. Hey. I couldn't let the day end with whatever this afternoon was.
Chloe, I want to talk to you about something, but I don't know how to talk about this.
You don't have to tell me anything you don't want to.
You remember that guy that we saw under this tree with that woman?
The ones who were making out?
That was my dad.
Oh. All right.
Oh, that's worse.
And that woman was definitely not my mom.
Oh.
The worst part is, I'm not surprised. I felt like my dad's been lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was. So when I saw he got a text from an unknown number asking him to meet, I thought I could catch him or something.
I'm so sorry, Rachel. I don't know what to say.
Neither do I. Chloe, I love my dad. I love him. And I never want to see his fucking face again.
When my dad died, I was so mad at him. For months, I felt wrong because half the time I thought of him, I wanted to scream. And the other half, I forgot.
Forgot that anything had changed. It's silly, but I've carried this photo around with me for years. It's from Mount Hood. My dad took me hiking there when I was 10, and it started raining, and I fell and broke my arm 3 miles from the car. I remember screaming like I was gonna die, but my dad, he carried me down the mountain. I still remember the smell of his coat and how calm he was and the sound of his voice and... He was just so strong, you know? I felt safe.
You trusted him.
Completely.
Here.
Chloe, I owe you an apology.
Hey, we were both kind of the queen of shitty.
No, I mean it. Whatever's going on between us, it's intense and new and awesome, and you had the courage to tell me that you feel it too. And I treated you like shit.
Courage? I don't know if I'd call it that. More like blind desperation. And maybe a slight buzz from that wine.
I just want you to know, I'm lucky that you were with me today. You're a badass, Chloe Price.
What?
Remember that biker asshole who wouldn't let you into the mill? You talked your way right past him.
You saw that?
And those skeevy douchebags who followed you upstairs? 2 against 1. But you wouldn't take any shit from them.
I'd be dead if you hadn't thrown that bottle.
You inspired me. What about Drew? When he was picking on Nathan, you got right in his face and called him out.
That was pretty sweet, actually.
See? You're the real thing, Chloe. I don't know anyone like you. Plus, you came along with me, no questions asked.
Well, I don't really need a good reason to ditch school.
I guess tomorrow there'll be hell to pay.
My mom might skip grounding and just go straight to the death penalty.
And my dad will definitely punish me with...
Fuck your dad.
Fuck him.
What I wouldn't give to leave this place and never look back.
What's stopping us?
Us? Are you serious?
There's nothing keeping me here. Not anymore.
So, if I came to you tomorrow and told you to pack your bags...
I'm serious. Let's do it, Chloe. Let's leave this place forever.
Okay.
Can I borrow your lighter?
Sorry, I'm quiet. Just
thank you.
This is I'm giving them the moment they need. And I know I'm a jokester a lot. I know I joke a lot, but this is one thing where my jokes aren't needed. I can do serious.
Come on.
Nothing else gets caught on fire. Don't tell me she saw everything going down. Oh, that was the end of chapter one. I'm probably close to an hour, maybe an over, I don't know. I missed two graffitis. Well, I'll go back and get him eventually. Okay, so this wasn't bad for the first chapter. This had way more heavy emotion to it. Life is totally messed up. Because as you see, you never know what's going on in a person's life. You never know what's going on in their household. And unfortunately for Rachel, everyone views her as this perfect person who has no flaws. But someone like Chloe takes the time to actually get to know them. Once you do, you see all the sides of the person that you spend the time with. The good, the bad, and the ugly. But true friends actually stick by you no matter what. There'll be fights from time to time, but Max Caulfield, when did she have a voice? Or will she have a voice? I don't remember. I know I could probably skip this, but I usually like the credits to roll so I can voice my thoughts on things. That's just the kind of person I am. But you know, people can also give others inspiration to do things they never thought possible. I definitely have inspiration. No matter what, I'm still gonna continue doing what I do. And, you know, down the road, I'll get to learn new things. I've got crazy things in mind, after all. Crazy things that I don't know about, but when I think of them, I'll put them in there. Anyway, I want to see what's going to be at the end. So, I'll see you there. Oh, okay. I just hit space and here I am. Okay, so I'm sorry, that's just funny. I'm just in here listening to the credits, and the next thing I know, bam, I just hit space, and here I am. So, 37% of people ran when 63% attacked. You know, I feel like if attacking can just instigate more issues. I think, in my personal opinion, I think running is the best option. But then again, I suppose it just depends on the situation. See, 64% of people were kind to Joyce. 36% of people were mean. I mean, come on, you can't be mean all the time. You gotta have some understanding and be like, okay, fine, I'll try, and stuff like that. 86% of people defended Nathan. 14% stayed out of the fight. I'm definitely gonna be looking at the opposite choices, I guess. 73% of people told Rachel, you're more than just friends. 27% didn't. Understandable. Next. Let's see. 42% took the money. 58% didn't. I took the money. I wonder how that's going to go down. See, 31% purchased pot from Frank, 69% didn't. 55% read Joyce's self-help book, 45% didn't. Interesting. I mean, I was exploring. It just happened. Let's see, 69% put the photo of William on the dresser, 31% didn't, 5% slipped, 95% didn't slip money into Joyce's purse. 5% did? Wait, what? Wait. I could have slipped money into Joyce's purse? Huh. See. 75% told Elliot they would go to the play. 25% didn't. 53% told Skip you'd like this demo. 46% didn't, and 1% told him that it was just okay. I'm surprised that there's an actual 1%. 77% finished the tabletop game, 23% didn't, 44% sabotaged Victoria's homework, 56% didn't, 57% told Rachel falling in love is stupid, 43% believed. Ninety-eight percent shared earbuds with Rachel, 2% didn't, and 93% jumped out of the train, while 7% didn't. Huh. Interesting. But again, you know, like I said in the last episode, I'm kind of going in between, going based off what Chloe would pick and what I would pick. So, again, it's up to you guys to decide which answer was what Chloe would do and which answer I would do. And Nova, I know you're probably gonna comment. I know you're watching me. But anyway, thank you everybody so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, please like, comment, and share. And don't forget to subscribe to see more in the future. I'll see you in the next chapter.